On the Medical Watch now, AI in the operating room.
Our medical reporter Dina Baer has more on how the technology is helping surgeons see cancer.
Artificial intelligence is changing medicine, helping doctors diagnose and treat patients with more precision. And now a suburban surgical team is turning to AI in the OR for an on-the-spot assist.
Microsurgery.
It's the tried and true hardware it takes to perform surgery.
Beck, we're going to open the dura. We're going to do 15 blade and then neuralon tack-ups.
Dr. Osama Khan uses a variety of tools as he works his way toward a mass in his patient's brain.
By releasing some fluid here, the brain's going to be nice and relaxed, and we can remove the tumor all in one piece.
A series of scans serve as a guide.
Some of the imaging modalities that we have can give us the impression of cancer, but in the end what we say is tumor's the rumor, tissue's the issue. Until we get tissue, we can't be 100% certain it's not cancer.
The surgical team worked for hours, ultimately removing the bulk of the tumor piece by piece, tissue that would typically go straight to the pathology lab for processing.
However, we're going to be using a new modality of an imaging system that's going to give us an immediate picture within 4 minutes that is artificial intelligence generated with no staining of the tissue, but a digital stain.
Just steps from the operating table, the tumor samples are loaded into a machine ready to process on the spot.
So the advantage of having the machine in the OR with me is I can literally look over my shoulder and see in real time, just like a scanning bed when you're scanning a photo in a scanner bed on a printer.
These look like metastatic cancer cells right here.
Neuropathologist Dr. Craig Horbinski stopped by to see the new technology in action.
So the surgeon is right there, the image is right there in the operating room. It's a matter of learning, okay, what does normal tissue look like versus abnormal tissue, and then just keep digging until you hit normal tissue and then you stop. I mean, that's where the real strength of this lies.
It may be fast, but is it accurate? The same tissue samples were put under the microscope in the hospital's pathology lab, where it was all eyes on deck.
Well, it was clear that it was abnormal tissue. It was not normal cerebellum tissue. There's way too many cells there. And under the microscope, by conventional methods, that's indeed what it still looked like to me, is poorly differentiated metastatic cancer.
The image from under the microscope is crisp, more defined compared to the picture upstairs in the OR. But the AI-generated image was clear enough for Dr. Khan to know how to proceed.
So the imaging that we're seeing, I do trust, because what I'm looking for is not something like next-generation sequencing of the tissue, molecular diagnosis. I want to know, do I see normal brain versus something that's very abnormal? So the faster we can get a cancer patient out of the OR, the better for them.
The more it does, the better it gets. And yeah, so I think this is really going to be transformative.
And that's the beauty of AI learning in medicine. The more the machine processes, the more precise it becomes. In the future, doctors hope the pathology images advance to show even more detailed information, like molecular markers in tumors. Back to you.